only 2 weeks away this time rather than months, and it was good to see you all. Wanted to start with a word of thanks this morning, and that thanks especially to Heather for putting today's service together, as well as all the choir members who have contributed so much to the events that will take place this morning. This is a very special service for us as we light our angel memorial tree in blessed memory of all those who have gone before us, and whose names we read this morning, and lights will shine for them. So a very special part of what we're doing this morning is that act of remembrance, and remembering the love that we all share, and that love that no matter where we are at in our lives, still continues to shine brightly. The angels this morning, if you have not had a chance to pick yours up, they will be available in the office throughout the week. So feel free to come in and pick up your angel if you haven't had a chance to do so. Our Christmas Eve services, registration is available for those. We have services scheduled for 5 p.m., 8 p.m., and 10 p.m. I encourage you to register as soon as possible to ensure that we have space for everybody. We are looking to the online, but you can also phone the office to express your preference. And we're asking that you register for only one service to ensure there's room for everybody who wants to come that evening. And one logistical detail, as the service ends this morning, please remain seated and wait for the ushers to dismiss you by row so that we don't crowd in the aisle and we can maintain our social distancing. All right, with those announcements, I'm going to ask Jerry to come forward.
Redeeming Love, a reading from Gloria Gaynor. Right from the beginning, God's love has reached. And from the beginning, man has refused to understand. But love went on reaching, offering itself. Love offered the eternal. We wanted the immediate. Love offered deep joy. We wanted thrills. Love offered freedom. We wanted license. Love offered community with God Himself. We wanted to worship at the shrine of our own minds. Love offered peace. We wanted approval for our wars. Even yet, love went on reaching. And still today, after 2,000 years, patiently, lovingly, Christ is reaching out to us today. Right through the chaos of our world, through the confusion of our minds, He is reaching, longing to share with us the very being of God. His love still is longing. His love still is reaching, right past the shackles of my mind, and the word of the Father became Mary's little son, and His love reached all the way to where I was.
Thank you. all among the poorest and most lowly. Today we will wander along with Isaiah, Mary, the shepherds, and the Magi. Some, like Isaiah, Mary, and the shepherds, wondered, why us? Others, the Magi, wondered about the sign and a king born as a baby. And we will wonder, too. Through our time together, I invite you to wonder what significance this event 2,000 years ago has for us right now. How can this still have meaning for us? In our wondering, may God touch us again by the power of the Christmas story. Not only the grandness of it, but also by the simplicity and humility of it. Angels are mentioned hundreds of times in the Bible. The angels appear throughout the Christmas story to remind us that those who have gone before us watch over us and guide us. During this service, we will remember our own special angels.
Thank you. celebrate what happened on the first Christmas nearly 2,000 years ago. But there were those before that who had longed greatly for a Messiah. That hope started with a promise from God and the anticipation in the heart of Israel. Christ was first prophesied to Israel when they were in Babylon captivity. And for centuries after, they waited expectantly for the Messiah who would ransom them and set them free. Here is the message from Judah and Jerusalem that was revealed to Isaiah, son of Amos. The people who walk in darkness will see a great light. For those who lived in a land of deep darkness, a light will shine. For a child has been born to us, a son has been given to us. He shoulders responsibility and is called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Another sleepless night. Fourth time this week. I don't know what's wrong with me. I just can't seem to rest. I can't get this message out of my mind. And yet, if I tell anybody about it, you know what people will say? They'll say, Isaiah, you old prophet, you're talking crazy. It's just a half-baked fantasy. Nothing will ever come of it. I don't know, maybe they're right. I mean, it's preposterous. And yet, it's so wonderful. I can't stop thinking about it. You see, God has revealed a great promise. A virgin will conceive and bear a son who will grow like a little shoot out of an old stump, bringing hope to those in despair. He would be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. I think that is what God is telling us. God is coming to show us a new way. No more of the powerful picking on the powerless. No more leaders who only look out for themselves. Instead, God will send a child who will be the light of the nations. But when will he come? How will we know when a child is here? Maybe I am going wild with ideas. Can an infant really bring about a new kingdom? Can a child threaten palaces or topple armies or bring rulers to their knees? It just seems ridiculous. But then again, when has God ever done things the way that you would expect? People may call me a madman, but a new day is coming, so I must tell people about it. I will believe in it and wait for it. And I'll dare to wonder about it, even if it means losing some more sleep.
Neil and Phyllis Mills, Don and Mary Anderson, Muriel and Bertie Dykman, Linda Orchard, Ross Wilson Saunders, Marina McCann Young, Hans and Helen McCann, Verna and George Seymour, William Darren Cook, Tammy Lynn Cook, Eldon and Ethel Painter, Bill and Maxine Lyons, Donald and Maxine Anderson, Earl and Sylvia Blackie, Teresa Thomas, Bob Colpitz, Charles A. Rose, Billy Lewis, Don and Mary Lou Hallett, John Ebbett, John and Margaret Duffy, Orville and Ruth Carr, Ian MacDonald, Keith Traer, Nicholas Lawrence, Mary and Charles Bolton, Jay and Bill Gorley, Marilyn Gorley Hills, Geraldine Krause, Christina Tina Harris, G. Irene and Sterling Cowie, Barbara and Clarence Munn, Joan and Reginald Peterson, Ross K. Cowie, Neil W. Cowie, Hedley S. Cowie, Sammy Niels Clements, Philip A. R. Carr, Corey Wilcott, Margaret and Alan Best, Billy and Tish Thune, Kathleen and Lawrence Lewin, Harold and Isabel Smith. Please join me in reciting the first verse of A Candle is Burning. A candle is burning,
a flame warm and bright, a candle of hope in December's dark night. While angels sing blessings from heaven's starry sky, our hearts we prepare now, for Jesus is nigh.
Responsive scripture reading, Luke 2, verses 1 to 7, the birth of Jesus. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register.
So Joseph also went out from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house belonging to David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him, and was expecting a child.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son.
She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room available for him.
I sure hope Joseph and I can find a place to stay tonight. I've never seen so many people in Bethlehem, but I guess everyone is here to register for the census. The baby should come any time now. It's hard to believe. Sometimes it feels like everything has happened so fast, and sometimes it feels like we've been waiting forever. I have to hand it to Joseph. He's really stuck by me through this. Most men would have divorced me once they learned I'd become mysteriously pregnant. But it seems he too realizes that something miraculous is happening. It might sound strange, but I know the baby's going to be a boy. The angel told me to name him Jesus. That he will be called the Son of the Most High, and that he will be a great king and reign forever. The angel told me so much, but I have to admit that I still feel scared. I don't even know how to raise a baby. Why could the angel have told me how to do that? Who am I to deliver the one who will deliver us? Why not somebody greater or wiser? I'm just a simple maiden, a lowly servant. What do I have to offer a king?
Thank you. Hansen, Joan Newbaugh, Dale Colpitz, Beverly O'Hara, Jim Burge, George and Doris Burge, Richard Burge, Ella and Kenneth O'Hara, Olive Davis, Herb Shepherd, Evelyn and Norman Sobey, Greta and Herb Shepherd, Ken and Mary Shepherd, Heather Shepherd, Ross Cameron, Ron Greenfield, Madeline Boyle, Phyllis and Abby Nicholson, John Pottle, Carolyn Pottle Gendron, Colin Keane, Brian Hitchcock, Sandy and Priscilla Ross, Henry and Grace McLeod, Terry Lynn Buttaker, Gordon Coburn, Pearl and Harry McGivney, Winona and Clarence Forbes, Mac McGivney, Bob McGivney, Charles McGivney, Ruby and Donald Fullerton, Vesta Sink, Dennis Fullerton, Ralph Fullerton, Donald John Jr. Fullerton, Tom and Eleanor McLeod, Nellie and Ward Bailey, Hazel and Harold Whitehead, Vince Whitehead, and the many animals in my life who have crossed the Rainbow Bridge. Excuse me. Bessie and Archie Gillis, Laura, Ruth, and Velma, Jean and Clifton Underhill, Art and Beverly, Nancy Collins, Lemuel and Mary Randall, Edwin and Margaret Hawkins, Mays and Audrey Dunham, Ted Wilkinson, Heather Wilkinson, and Doug Hildebrand. And will you recite with me? A candle is burning,
a candle of peace, a candle to signal that conflict must cease. For Jesus is coming to show us the way, a message of peace humbly laid in array.
Please stand for the scripture reading. Luke 2, verses 8 to 12, the shepherds. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
You may be seated.
Good morning.
Still can't believe it myself. There were angels. And they were talking about us shepherds. And they were in the skies. And my ears are still ringing from all of the singing. I was so afraid. And then they said, don't be afraid. So then I was only a little afraid. And wow. We met the Messiah tonight. Us shepherds of all people. I still can't believe it. It's strange that the Messiah was born in such a dumpy place. I mean, aren't kings usually born in palaces? And where was everyone else? I thought that all of the big religious leaders would have been there. But not tonight. It was just us and the animals. Usually when important things happen, we're the last to know. Strange. For once in our lives, the last were first. Well now, we've got a story to tell. I wonder what people will say. Do they think they would believe us? I know we're just shepherds, but this is big news.
scripture is taken from Luke 2, verses 13 to 20, the angels. Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying,
Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those from whom his favor rests.
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about.
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them.
But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Please be seated.
Please rise for the reading of the responsive scripture. Matthew 2, verses 1-11.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him."
And Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him."
After they had heard the king, they went on their way. And the star that they had seen when it rose went ahead of them, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed.
On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. And then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thus ends the reading. Please be seated.
What really makes a good gift? I'm not sure anymore. Have you ever been in the marketplace and looked around at all the goods and wondered, what on earth am I going to buy for the person that is so special? What can I give them to tell them they are important to me? Well, my companions and I have traveled from way out east. And it took us many days and nights to get here, traveling across some pretty bleak countryside. But we were determined to pay homage to the child who had been born a king. We saw the news of his birth written in the sky, and we followed his star all the way to the tiny town of Bethlehem. We wanted to honor him and to bless him, so we brought the most beautiful, expensive gifts money could buy. Gold, fit for royalty. Incense of the type that only priests dare burn. And myrrh, an extravagant oil for anointing, should he suffer any wounds. These are the kinds of gifts that would normally be surefire hits. But you know, when we went in and spent a moment in his presence, I experienced something that I had never experienced before. I felt like I needed to back away, but at the same time, I felt like I needed to draw closer. It's strange, but even though he was the little child, and I am a man with great wisdom and stature, I was the one who felt foolish. I was the one who felt vulnerable. And when we laid our gifts before him, I almost felt like they weren't enough, like I should be giving more. Not in the sense of giving more extravagant possessions or riches or wealth. It might sound strange, but he didn't seem to need that stuff. His glory came from something different. Instead, I felt like I should be giving him more of me, as if I should give my life to him. gold I bring to crown him again, king forever, ceasing never over us all to reign.
Frankincense to offer have I, incense owns a deity nigh, prayer and praising, all men raising, worship him God on high.
Lights will shine forth. Ned and Francis Watling, Bill and Francis Forward, Paul Reed, Bob Foster, Jean Foster, Eugene Foster, Mildred Bamford, Donald Bamford, Doris Amos, Blair Amos, Hazel and Scott Kuplin, Thelma and Harvey Tate, Marlene Tate Nicole, Jackie Sproul, Tom and Evelyn Hick Austin, Neil and Mary Hicks, Tina Hicks Valente, Weldon and Barbara Colwater, Pearl Smear, Irvin Archibald, John Smear, Brenda Smear, Anna Purley, Edward Sonny Purley, Spotty Purley, Robert Sr. and Eva Bartlett, Henry and Laura Baker, Lori Hoffman. Let us join together. A candle is burning, a candle of joy, a candle to welcome the Mary Mary's glory. Our heart fills with wonder, and eyes light and glow, as joy brightens winter like sunshine on the snow.
I was walking home from school. It was a cold winter day. I took a shortcut through the woods, and, well, I lost my way. It was getting late, and I was scared, alone. But then a kind old man, he took my hand, and he led me home. The mama couldn't see him, oh, but he was standing there. And I knew in my heart, he was the answer to my prayer. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours to show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love. When life held troubled times and had me down on my knees, there's always been someone to come along and comfort me. A kind word from a stranger, to lend a helping hand, a phone call from a friend, just to say I understand. But ain't it kind of funny, at the dark end of the road, that someone lights the way with just a single ray of hope? From somewhere up above, they come to you and me in our darkest hours to show us how to live, to show us how to give, to guide us with the light of love. They wear so many faces, show up in the strangest places to grace us with their mercy in our time of need. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours to show us how to live, to show us how to give, to guide us with the light of love, to guide us with the guidance. We light this tree to celebrate your light of love. The Angel Memorial Tree.
Let us pray. Holy and gracious God, we come before you this day as your beloved children. We come together to remember. Remember all those beloved angels of ours who have gone before us. We come before you with our grief and our tears. We come before you with our hope and our love for all that they have been for us. We ask you to keep them ever close to us. We ask you to bless those who grieve, those who can hardly imagine what this Christmas will be like without them, some for the first time. We ask you, God, send your angels to be with them. constantly reassure and remind them that your love knows no bounds. As you send angels to Mary and Joseph and the shepherds, saying to them as you say to us, do not be afraid, for I bring you good news of great joy, for Emmanuel, God with us, has come. Help us to remember always that you are Emmanuel, that you are with us, each and every step of our journey of life and into the great beyond. We ask you, God, to hear us. As we look before you now in the silence of our hearts, the names of those people and places and situations that need your special loving care this day. Embrace them in your loving arms, O God, and grant them your healing touch. God, we ask you to be with us, bless us, strengthen us in our faith as we go forward into the days ahead. Help us to be your angels in this place, those who proclaim the good news of hope, peace, joy, and love that come from you. We ask this and all things in the name of Emmanuel, the one who taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Played a poverty last night for some old folks. They were dancing and smiling at me. Except this old man alone at a table, as if there's some place that he'd rather be. So I said, sir, can I play something for you? Something special that you'd like to hear. When he looked out at me, he was smiling. But his eyes couldn't hide the tears. He said, play me the waltz of the angels, and I'll close my eyes and pretend. Oh, play of the angels, so I can dance with my angel again.
the song I remember. That's the one that she loved the best. It was playing the night that I met her. And it was plain when we laid her to rest. Oh, play me the waltz of the angel, and I'll close my eyes and pretend. Play me
sometimes I wonder what it would have been like to stand in Bethlehem the night that Jesus was born. I wonder what stories the stars would have told, how the angels sounded, and what the presence would have been like in the manger. I can't help but believe there had to have been something different in the air, something that made people question what sacred thing had just transpired. I suspect that many people in Bethlehem missed it, but some were allowed to know and feel and sense the weight of Jesus' entrance into humanity. And while they probably didn't understand every intricate detail, they knew that night was different. They knew that night was special, and they knew that that night was holy.
Thank you.
the angel's messenger. May you experience the true and lasting peace that comes only from God. May you rejoice at what lies ahead. And may you be filled with the love of God in every fiber of your being. May the blessings of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you now and remain with you always. Amen.